Hello and welcome to this celebration of the sixth Sunday of Easter.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My sisters and brothers, we have come together once again to give honor, glory, and praise to our God, who promised always to be with us. He sent us his Spirit, who lives within each one of us, and binds us all together, always, but especially now at this moment when we're worshiping God together. As we begin this celebration of his love, let us allow the Lord to embrace us in that beautiful peace that only he can give. Lord Jesus, risen Savior, you revealed God's love for sinners. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, risen Savior, you died on the cross for sin. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, risen Savior, you rose from the dead for salvation. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. And now with joy in our hearts, let us give all the glory to our God. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of the risen Lord, and that what we relive in remembrance, we may always hold on to what we do, Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Philip went down to the city of Samaria and proclaimed the Christ to them. With one accord, the crowds paid attention to what was said by Philip when they heard it and saw the signs he was doing. For unclean spirits, crying out in a loud voice, came out of many possessed people, and many paralyzed and crippled people were cured. There was great joy in that city. Now, when the apostles in Jerusalem heard that Samaria had accepted the word of God, they sent them Peter and John, who went down and prayed for them, that they might receive the Holy Spirit, for it had not yet fallen upon any of them. They had only been baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Then they laid hands on them, and they received the Holy Spirit. The word of the Lord.
And sing praise to you, sing praise to your name. Come and see the works of God, his tremendous deeds among the children of Adam. Let all the has changed the sea into dry land. Through the river they passed on foot. Therefore let us rejoice in him. He rules by his might forever. Done for me. Blessed be God who refused me not my prayer or his kindness. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, sanctify Christ as Lord in your hearts. Always be ready to give an explanation to anyone who asks you for the reason for your hope. But do it with gentleness and reverence, keeping your conscience clear, so that when you are maligned, those who defame your good conduct in Christ may themselves be put to shame. For it is better to suffer for doing good, if that be the will of God, than for doing evil. For Christ also suffered for sins once, the righteous for the sake of the unrighteous, that he might lead you to God. Put to death in the flesh, he was brought to life in the spirit. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you always. The Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot accept, but it neither sees nor knows him. But you know him, because he remains with you and will be in you. I will not leave you orphans. I will come to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me, because I live and you will live. On that day, you will realize that I am in my Father, and you are in me, and I in you. Whoever has my commandments and observes them is the one who loves me. And whoever loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love him and reveal myself to him." The Gospel of the Lord. This Gospel passage takes place the night before Jesus died. The setting is the table at the Last Supper. Judas has left the room. Jesus speaks about his coming death now. The apostles wonder how they can go on without him. Well, Jesus wants them to know that his death is not the end. They will witness his resurrection and his ascension into heaven. His words to them are mysterious and timeless. He speaks of these things not as a moment in history, but as an opening moment, opening of an ongoing event, in which they and those who follow will be part of. It is an ongoing adventure. And the best news is that he will be with them in this adventure in a new way. You heard the words of Jesus in today's gospel. I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. I will not leave you orphaned. I will come to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me. You will know that you are in me, and I in you. And that, my sisters and brothers, is when the ongoing adventure begins. We call it Pentecost Sunday, the coming of the promised Holy Spirit upon the church, and we are the church. We will celebrate Pentecost Sunday in just 2 weeks. The Holy Spirit, the mysterious but real way in which Jesus continues to be present to us, the way he will inspire us, the way he will lead us and teach us and give us his wisdom, his understanding, his knowledge, his divine courage, and above all, love. My sisters and brothers, we are on the most wondrous, the most beautiful, the most joyous adventure there could ever be. Jesus in you, and you in him, the Holy Spirit. So, my sisters and brothers, even in the midst of this pandemic, be assured. Jesus says to us today, as he said to the apostles, I will not leave you orphaned. So do not let your hearts be troubled. I am with you, and I will never leave you. And now, my sisters and brothers, let us profess together what we all believe. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. On the cross, Jesus surrendered his life to the Father for all people. Let us pray in the confidence of this surrender.
For the church, that we may find ways to both preach the word and serve our neighbor, especially during the pandemic, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the health, safety, and encouragement of the medical professionals, hospital workers, and all essential workers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the swift recovery of those suffering with the effects of COVID-19, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have recently died, including Jorge Casales and Gloria Wilkinson, may they rest and rejoice in the peace, joy, and love of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the intentions in our Book of Hope, our prayer chain, and for the intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Good and gracious God, your Holy Spirit speaks through us. Grant what our advocate inspires us to ask this day, for as always we pray, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands, for the praise of the Lord, for our good and the whole house of the church.
May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O God, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed and raised from the dead. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, Overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim with us. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, Father, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, Father, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the offering of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with the Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Peter Claver, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Leonard, our Bishop, and his assistant Bishop Juan Miguel, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There, we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And with your spirit. Let us offer to one another a sign of Christ's peace.
You take
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Sisters and brothers, I invite you to receive Jesus in a spiritual communion this day. I invite you to, either out loud or to yourself, repeat after me, meaning every word. Jesus, I believe you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things. And I desire to receive you into my being. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come now spiritually into my heart. I embrace you with all my love. And unite myself wholly to you. Never let me be parted from you.
Let us pray.
Almighty ever-living God, who restore us to eternal life and the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food through Christ our Lord. My sisters and brothers, this Thursday is the feast of the Ascension of the Lord into heaven. And so we're going to have a special Mass for Thursday, the Feast of the Ascension. You can find it, of course, as you are watching now, either on our website or on Facebook or on YouTube. And just click on the Ascension of the Lord, and we'll be there. Just one more announcement. I hope you enjoyed the fun video that we sent out to you this past week. We had fun doing it, and we thought you really would love a time to have some fun, too, to have a laugh. But some people have asked, you know, who was that nun playing the piano? So just in case you didn't recognize Sister Mary Timothy, that's who it was. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Amen.